I'm Arthur Boyle of Performance Appraisal Services. We're residential real estate appraisers with a company founded in 1994 by Mike Gianelli and I in the basement of my house in Malden. We've since grown to have offices in Malden and Pembroke. We serve the eastern Mass counties, including Cape Cod. A good client for us is an attorney or a private landowner or a private property owner who's going through a probate process or a divorce division of property. Call us at 781-293-6900. Ask for Arthur Boyle or Amanda Boyle Grazioso. Our first name is Performance.
All right, I'd like to open this meeting of the Pembroke Conservation Commission, January 23rd, 2017. It's now 7:32. Let's see, members present are Administrative Assistant Mary Ginney, Art Egerton, Greg Walsh, Sharon Tuells, myself, Andy Stevenson, Scott Glauben, and Bob Clarke. Rick Madden will be right back. So we have our first appointments not until 7:40, which I believe is here already.
And you have to hold on. You guys all got copies of the annual report, or did I forget? I didn't mail them to you?
I didn't.
Let's hold on, and I will go
okay.
Print them out for you. And don't say anything.
I'm like, wait a minute, I didn't get any of that.
Lost any more weight?
Huh?
Lost any more weight?
I can't hear you.
Did you lose any more weight?
Not much. I mean, I kind of, you know, I just want to lose X amount and then...
It's very difficult to do when your wife is in set condition, sir. Right.
Well, actually, it's actually a lot easier because then you're busy doing stuff, so you just forget to eat.
Oh, yeah, that's true. You could do this, do that, but... And towards the end, it was like they said, like, sympathy weight or whatever it is. And let me tell you, it happens. It does.
I think sometimes I'm too lazy to eat.
Yeah, right. Well, it gets too late at night. And then you're like, ah, forget it, you know? Yeah. Like during fishing season, I'll drop 15, 20 pounds when I actually fish because I don't eat. I don't sleep when I don't eat.
Yeah.
That's how it is.
I get on that thing on the computer, myfitnesspal.com.
Yeah.
And it monitors everything. Be honest and put everything in there, I'll tell you exactly.
Yeah, I mean, the one thing that, I mean, just cutting out sugar, that was the the biggest thing for me.
Soda, drink a little more.
I mean, no, it's any carbs.
Oh, yeah.
It's easier said than done, of course, you know. But, I mean, I lost 20 pounds in the first month just cutting out sugars.
Yeah. It was basically water.
It's amazing how much sugar we
eat. Oh, yeah. But I also feel like I have like 10 times more energy.
Mm-hmm. Without the sugar.
Yeah.
Greg Hanley?
Apparently I've changed my name.
Oh, Greg Hanley. I'm going to change that to Manly.
Yeah, that did definitely describe me.
Greg Hanley is an actual guy, you know.
I don't, but not on this board.
It's from Selectman, isn't it? Oh, no, yeah, never mind.
Oh,
yeah, you're right.
That's us. I don't like...
I don't know.
He was just standing in for a few days.
It's all good.
It's my alter ego.
What is this now? I just signed it. I didn't look at it.
That is the extension for the orders of condition.
That's Andy only. Look at that guy. He's so cool.
Normally I try.
You're signing that, but did we all approve that letter?
Thank you for your donation of $250 to Pembroke Watershed Association.
I never voted for that.
You don't have to.
With my glasses.
That's what I thought, too.
I'm just... So, actually...
After your donation we can't take the donation. It has to go to a tax-exempt organization.
Right.
So I'm thinking out loud here, but...
It comes because...
This isn't me. I can just leave.
He works for the company and does so many hours volunteer for open space. So
Mary, did I change my name?
Every year.
What did you do?
But I can't go to the town.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. No.
I just wasn't sure. It was my alter ego.
That's not something that's something we have to vote on.
No,
thank, or a thank you letter.
I don't know.
Here we go. Oh, that's Scott's. Thank you. Thank you.
Open Space Committee, Open Space Committee.
No, it's all right. I didn't know if I wasn't needed.
I was giving him a hard time all about it. So I was giving him a hard time, so it's all good.
I didn't even notice.
You know, I do that all the time.
Yeah, it's all good. In case you hadn't noticed, I do it too every time I announce names, so.
Have you handed this in yet?
No, you guys have to review and approve it.
Okay.
And it has to be in by next week.
I got to do what?
Hmm?
I got to do what?
She said your name was left out in the annual report. She's going to add it on there.
Oh.
Wasn't it 2016 where we approved the highway project to go through Route 14? It was 2015?
2015.
Time flies.
Is it too late to nominate?
I don't think they have any openings right now.
If there was, I would nominate Rick to be the chairman.
Of what?
Open Space Committee.
You like Poison Ivy?
That works. I don't go to those meetings, so that's fine.
Really?
You're supposed to go to the chairman.
Yeah. You really kind of need to be the point of contact, the more I think about it.
I think you should handle the Wild Parsnip project yourself naked.
I'm not even sure how to respond to that.
Yes.
I think the best is when you propose getting the hog.
Yes.
Getting a wild hog.
Has everybody read the...
We accept the report of the Conservation Commission for the annual year 2016.
Right. We just needed to add Sharon's name on it, and Mary is going to take care of that. Okay, I just wanted that up there. So motion's been made and seconded.
Sorry, I have one comment. It seems like there must be more that this board did than just this, like, three or four paragraphs. It was a whole year, right? Are we missing anything important that we did? Three paragraphs about three different things.
Right, well, they're not broken out individually. It's 27 determination. I mean, everything's kind of listed up here, so.
Right, but then they talk about three of them. There's anything worth talking about besides those three things? No?
Relying, preserve. Indian Head. I mean, we just approved the other one at Ludlam's Ford. I mean, that was great.
Yeah, right.
Everything else will be the rest of it will be on next year's when they start the trailhead stuff and go from there, right? So.
Yeah, we could spend a lot of time on the wild parsnip.
Yeah.
Right.
And going to do a lot more. It'll be there. It's not going away anytime soon.
It's all gone.
So motion's been made and seconded. All in favor? Or did that satisfy any questions that you have?
That's fine.
Okay. All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed?
I move we accept the report of the open space committee publishing the town report for year 2016.
Second.
Okay. Motion's been made and seconded to accept the report of the open space committee. Any discussion on that or questions? Okay. All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Thank you. Okay, it is now 7:40. I just figured out where I stuck my agenda here. And I'd like to open the hearing for the abbreviated order of resource area delineation for an ANRAD for 70 Old Cart Path Lane. DEP file number SE56-977, and this is for verification of edge of wetland resource areas. Anybody here for that? Hi, welcome.
Anyone going to present?
Do we have any presenters here for that? Or?
You mean the gentleman that filed the application is not here?
Right. Saya, however you said it. Saya?
CC, something like that.
Whose name is on that phone number there? Whose name is on the lower right hand side?
SAIA.
Prepared for Stephen, SAIA. By whom? Is it Grady?
Yeah, Grady. Well, Grady did it.
Oh, here he is.
Stephen.
Okay, thank you.
Hi, how you doing? Come on up.
At the park in Kingston. Sorry. Busy night here. So we open the hearing.
We're on the hot seat.
Yes, we do.
You're
what's your name, sir?
Kevin Gray, Grady Consulting, representing the applicant for the ANRAD. We had John Zimmer.
We got it, for instance?
South River Environmental. Delineated the wetland November 2015. Homeowners taking some time to decide to submit and
do you have the green cards?
Get the wetland line approved.
That's not for that. It's not a notice of intent. It's just a name.
You found these flags with surveying?
Yes. Yep, so we surveyed the property, located all the flags, took them on the plan, and we're submitting them. This bordering vegetated wetland and the top of bank for approval of the resource area delineation. Not proposing any construction or anything at this point. So we have to lock in this line so that we can do conceptuals. If we have a moving line, we can't really do conceptual planning.
So top of bank being
Intimate Street.
But the bank
on
that side.
Yes,
you're not looking at either bank, only
correct.
Only the bank one on bank.
You got it. Yeah, the other bank is
Okay. So it would be a new bank. Yeah. That's what I was concerned about.
Is that updating an old chart or is this the first time this has ever been done around there?
I don't think the wetlands have been delineated since Old Car Path was built in the early 70s. That I'm aware of.
So has it changed significantly?
Not that I know of.
Now that's the area is basically the same that one there. The only delineation would be north. What's this way?
This is north up
south.
The page.
Okay. In other words, south of there, has been delineated, but not that area there.
These lots here.
Those
probably.
Are the ones on the side by the barn and going back towards the old bog and all.
Correct. correct. So we had an independent company, South River Environmental, John Zimmer, excellent wetland scientist, has been working in this field for years. He went out and independently delineated this line, and we just located the flags and put them on the plan.
Is there any question that that's an intermittent stream and not a perennial?
He clearly indicates in his report that it's intermittent.
What is the definition of an intermittent stream as opposed to a river, and what is the delineation of if it's an intermittent stream, what are the boundaries? I guess, well, what is the difference between an intermittent stream, and why does that qualify as an intermittent stream?
If it dries, Mary, do you have any exact word? There's something about it being dry so much of a...
The intermittent stream is shown on...
USGS maps.
USGS maps as perennial, and qualified person has to determine that it has not flowed 4 days in a calendar year.
It's always flowing.
And not during a drought.
Always flowing.
I'm an abutter, and I've lived here in this house on 145 Mountain Avenue since 1959. When they used to stock the river underneath Mountain Avenue with trout, I'd fish there. I've trapped this stream up behind all of these other properties, not delineated here, but the ones down to the stream. That stream has run for as long as I have been living here, and I have actually caught fingerling trout that migrated back up the river for a while. I question whether it's an intermittent stream. It's never been
natural. Natural springs right up off of Forest Street that start. It's two brooks that start and go along there.
Right.
And natural springs right up at Forest Street, right before Bonnie. There's a natural spring that flows that way. And then the other one goes the other way, and the North River comes out by Clarke Street.
How do you treat it differently between a permanent stream and intermittent?
If it's a intermittent stream, it has a top of bank associated with it and a 100-foot buffer zone. Typically, there's a border and vegetated wetland that's associated with the stream that has a 100-foot buffer zone. So that's usually the 100-foot buffer zone that dictates. In a perennial stream, there's a 100-foot riverfront zone, and then an additional another 100 feet, so the 200-foot riverfront zone.
So
those 200 feet are all resource area.
So are we looking at a 100-foot buffer?
Okay.
Is that accurate on this plan? The 100-foot wetland buffer to the intermittent, what they're calling an intermittent stream, is that buffer? 100-foot wetland buffer in effect?
I don't think it is yet.
As of now.
We have to approve it, right?
This plan is calling it a intermittent stream.
Right.
So the plan is showing the wetland buffer, right?
So that's a buffer to the bordering vegetated wetland.
Yeah. To the border. So it's only showing, it's not using the top of the bank in any form.
Okay.
If it was a perennial stream, we'd be using the top of the bank as the primary reference point to get our distances for protection, right?
Of the riverfront.
Yeah, or the riverfront.
So there's multiple resources in that case. There's the 100-foot buffer zone and the associated work within that and how that affects the bordering vegetated wetland, and then separate from that is the 100-foot and 200-foot zones associated with the riverfront and how the proposed, you know, any work associated
with that. There are two different ways of determining the area that could be under the control of this board. Sometimes it could be one way and sometimes it could be the other. But the first thing we'd have to determine is the status of the stream. And is there, you're saying intermittent, do you have proof of that it's going to
It's indicated on the 2015 use topographic map as an intermittent stream. And that's the first definition of the how you determine that.
Rick wants the minutes.
River.
We're supposed to be paying attention to this.
What we've done in the past is if it's not, if it's shown as perennial and we think it's intermittent, then we typically try and prove that out through the witnessing it for consecutive days. Also, using stream stats to determine if it's got it's a mile, a square mile of.
There's a whole big formula.
There's a pretty long definition, but the very first says definition is as shown on the USGS map.
Yeah.
And you're saying this is not shown in the USGS.
It's shown as intermittent.
In 2015.
Yep.
And have you done the stream stats analysis?
No. We as soon as it's shown as intermittent. And I don't do the delineation. This is an independent company who did this. He checked that, and then he also physically was on site to delineate. So in his report, stream is identified as intermittent on the USGS topographic map, MassGIS 2015.
Does anybody?
But this gentleman's saying it's constantly running.
It's constantly running. For
so he's going off a map and actually didn't do any of the other steps, right?
No, I'm just asking this.
Yeah. I mean, I like I said, I'm not an independent, you know, surveyist, and but I can tell you for 50 years, yes, has there been a low ebb on drought, but never to a point where it's not been running. And in fact, most of the time, it's got a very, very good flow.
What about an independent assessment? Has anybody done like plant surveys or species surveys or any other work? Would this be done after this determination or prior to?
As far as the bordering vegetated wetland, yes, we've submitted a report that indicates what plants are upland and wetland. Relative to the stream, it's simply USGS and flow and bank.
Endangered species, newts, anything, that type of stuff?
It's not located in the estimated habitat.
But what if they were there? I mean,
Rick, it's not relevant to the NRAD, though.
That's what I'm asking. I asked if it was. It would be done before or after. It would be afterwards, then, right?
Yes.
Okay.
That's what I was getting at.
We're merely stating that we don't have to apply to NHESP, basically.
Unless it's determined to be a...
Unless it's determined as habitat or vernal pools or whatever.
Or a river.
We wouldn't go to NHESP with a river. The river would simply be to you under the Wetlands Protection Act for impacts to the riverfront zone. Based on work within a 200 and 100 foot riverfront area.
Right. Just for my brook stream, same thing, different?
I'm sure there's a distinction somewhere. I couldn't tell you exactly what it is.
Does the conservation
looking for your recommendation as you're moving our famous maps. And yet we're having a dispute that the maps may not be 100% correct.
Correct. I can't speak to the river flowing for the last 50 years. It's not possible for me to speak to that. I'm merely going by the regulation and also what my independent delineator indicated in his report.
I can see different possibilities. One is if we go by this plan, which is based on maps that we're told we're supposed to be using, and we didn't go along with this plan, all the abutters have a right to appeal our decision because they don't think that what's on the plan is substantiated in the field.
Correct.
But I'm not sure we have the ability to say it's wrong because we haven't been, none of us have been in the field. I don't feel that I can dispute either side right at the moment.
I've been in the field. I know the area, crab fish hunted all this whole area.
That runs all year.
But it only has to be dry 4 days of the year. You haven't been there every day.
Oh, no, I'm just saying.
Not like other people who have been, I mean.
I know the area pretty well.
I've hiked it regularly since I moved here, and I've seen it slow down in the hot summer, but it's always runs. It wasn't never ever dry, so that's all I know.
Yeah.
How would you even determine something like that? I mean, if you're saying that the burden of proof is you got to stand out there for a year or something to figure it out, I mean, how is that even doable?
Well, that's my dilemma right now, is our regulations say to use the USGA map classification.
If they've never come out to look at it, please.
We have people that we believe that say the map is wrong, yet it's how do we change? It's not our job to change the map. I'm trying to find out whose job it is to challenge the map. And I say our job is to look at what's presented with the facts that are presented and go from there. I mean, if we take and say, no, we don't accept this, what grounds do we have to not accept what the regulations say we should accept?
Is that map this map?
Proper.
The one that you're looking
it's
at?
It's questionable.
The same here?
I believe it's the same
one. Yeah, it's the same plan. Yep. Yep.
So all of this wetland buffer, whether it be upland wetland or wetland bordering the vegetated land from top of bank, that is, all these measurements are dependent upon whether that's an intermittent stream.
No.
Okay. So
your wetland flags are for wetland buffer.
Oh, border, yeah, that's what I mean.
Don't border vegetated wetland. It's nothing to do with the bank. If we call it a perennial stream, and all of the measurements will be off the top of the bank.
Well, there'd be two. There'd be two more buffer lines.
Yeah.
On the same.
There'd be two more buffer lines, and one at 100 foot off the bank, one at 200 foot off the bank, and one for the vegetated wetland.
So it's very important as to whether it's an intermittent stream or a river or whatever the other definition is, as to what these measurements are and how much you can encroach upon them, correct?
That's correct. Yeah, it is very important.
So absolutely. It's very important.
Absolutely. Do we have the right? Do we have the right to bring up
But it's still the wetland person can't change the plan. It's who can change, who can overrule the plan, the map.
Well, right. Right.
Stevenson's calculations, can't you?
Yes.
If you think it's a perennial stream, if it's shown as a perennial stream, the map that we have in our office, it might be older and it does show it as perennial.
Okay.
And if it's intermittent, you can run stream stats.
Yep, there's as we said earlier, there's a whole series of, I don't have the regulations in front of me. I could go through them step by step if I had them here.
Right.
I'm not prepared to do that at this point.
And that needs to be requested by... Not by conservation or by somebody else. The test to determine that.
We hit the first one, the first test.
Yeah.
And we passed that, as intermittent based on what the mapping says. And it ends for us there.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Unless there's some directive
otherwise.
Could I ask a question? By we passed that, that's a the licensed firm you're talking about that did the study?
Correct.
Yeah, so
everything comes up to me and we'll take care.
Okay, so are we, as people who let the property, is that just a question? Is it, we got one firm that says that that's the way it is?
Mm-hmm.
And is that like, how do we get another firm to look at it and say, this is maybe disputable? And where does the responsibility for that determination come from?
Right, right.
In terms of people who have an interest in the wetlands.
Mm-hmm.
I can't question, you know, what's being offered to you by another credential firm.
Right, and
you
we don't
have a certain idea of how many credential firms that you will listen to and who's responsible for providing them.
We don't have the results of that anywhere, right? Of your stream test, you don't have that on your own.
No, we have the delineation wetland summary that I submitted.
Okay.
And then in the comments below, that he indicates how he determined the status of the river.
Okay. Is that on?
I think you do have the right to question it.
Did you say Mary?
It's at what point we had the right to question it, because I don't want to be in an appeal process.
Do we have that map?
When, in fact, the very beginning of the process should have been slowed down to make sure that we had.
Can we find out the date on that?
Firm operating on behalf of the owner.
Right.
Of the property. That automatically makes it not wrong, it just makes it suspect in terms of, so at what point does this board say, in light of what property owners that abut the property believe they know, does this board have the responsibility to say, you know, in light of what's up for grabs here, and I understand your point that you got to go by the,
right,
you know, what the maps are, so I mean, I understand that, but obviously that's why we're here, and that's why you're doing the
right
hearing, is people who actually live there,
yeah,
can actually disagree, and I don't want to like go into an appeal process when in fact there's, I think, some significant issue whether or not in fact it should even be at that point.
Right.
Maybe we need to back up and say, okay, let's do whatever you guys think is the best process to at least to get our ground zero level done, and then we take the next step in terms of whether or not there's
right
objectivity that's being presented to abutting property owners.
Would you be, and your client be willing for a 30-day postponement, allowed to say, reschedule this in 30 days and give the abutters a chance to research what you think is right for the area? I mean, we have to go on what's presented to us. You're saying what has been presented to us. You people all believe us that some of the information isn't correct, and we just need.
Okay.
Yeah, we need something to go on. We can't just pull it out of the hat.
Right.
I guess my point was, if someone presents something to you, which has been done, which is by definition in the interest of the owner, then at that point you have some kind of responsibility to establish objectivity when in fact the plan that you have in front of you is being presented on behalf of the owner, when in fact there's a larger area here that has to be considered.
You're correct there, but the fact that we're really disputing is what is on a USGA, which is am I wrong saying a federal?
It's federal.
It's a federal map.
Right.
Produced by the government for people to use for the purpose it's being used for.
Correct.
So, and so basically, you know, we're almost tied to believing what they're giving us, unless somebody can prove to us that what's on that map is not correct.
Well, Mary said there's another map.
What you're asking is no, we do not have the authority to override the USGA map in this. Oh, this is just to accept the line here.
Correct. That part I understand.
Right.
I think I got that.
Right.
The part that I would say is you don't have to rule now. You can choose to give appropriately interested people an opportunity to take a look at it ourselves, rather than automatically be in the appeal process. Well, I'm not familiar with this whole process.
Right. Well, if we approve the guidelines that were given by the laws of federal and state and everything else, which is going by this and what the owner and the other person did, you have the right to appeal our findings.
Correct.
And
correct.
With no question.
Right.
That's besides us. That's neither here nor there. The same way he could appeal our findings.
Correct.
On one way or the other.
Correct.
No question asked. So.
Right.
The question is, does the board have the ability to override the findings on this map? No, we don't. I guess that's the easiest.
Then what's this meeting even about? I don't
understand. It's about accepting the what's called the ANRAD, the line. That's it.
Would you explain that to me?
Okay, so that's to accept the line.
Yes.
The determination, whether it's an intermittent stream or a river, says how far you can go over that line, come encroach that line, be close to the line. That's the first article. We haven't even got into the second part, which is anybody here from the highway department?
From the highway department?
Yeah. I've lived in this house since 1959.
Yeah.
They have now added, there are three culverts on Mountain Avenue that flow right into this property and come out right along WF 25 and come over right about TV 39. And that all of that water from Terra Drive jumps my curb, washes out my driveway continually, and then flows down through this whole land out to that river. So that river, whenever it rains from the street, is extremely well running.
Okay.
When we had the snowstorm, we were flooded out there.
I get flooded if I don't keep that clean, which I have done all these years, with the help of the highway department, goes out there with a machine every now and again. It's pretty well blocked up at this point in time.
Yeah.
But nobody has even mentioned about the water flow that comes in off the street and how that might be impacted with anything that happens out here on that lot.
Stormwater management would be part of a notice of intent for the property. Where it would have to comply with those regulations. So that's a separate hearing for if and when it comes to that. The notice of intent is a different filing than what we have here this evening.
Okay,
so
I guess I'm just making this aware.
Understood,
yeah.
Understood, but that's the stormwater management falls under, they'd have to meet those and show that it's capable in the notice of intent hearing. Whether this developer or another one develops it, it would still have to come back in front of this commission.
I think you
should. Nobody
knows if this property is being looked at to be developed or not. We do not know that.
Right. Neither do we, and that.
Okay.
That's not what we're here.
But how can you okay something if you don't even know what they want
to
do?
I don't understand what there is to even okay. Because they already accept the map, so it's done. Why? I don't get the point.
I think it's for the future, and it's for people who have time out front to deal with these things instead of, you know, just rambling right over you. It's a process, I'm green as you can be. It's a process that has steps along every way and points of breaking and saying, okay, look at it again. And I think that's all different issues that you'll be able to address with this board well. And you're very articulate, and I like, and that's really good. You put your points across. I think for what we're doing, our hands are tied as a board. This map may not be correct, but it's what we have, and it's what we're supposed to make our determinations on. We can't change that. He can't change that. What we can do is give an extension for him to give us more information and come back in 30 days. I think that's a very, I'm willing to go that distance. And then the other things that you're addressing will all come down the road if and when something is decided to do what and when. This is merely a dedicated. So I think they have the right to appeal this process as well, right?
Yes.
After it's done, right?
Yeah, and this is just for the end.
Though the only person that can really extend this hearing is right here.
Now, we cannot.
The proponent has the right to say, I don't want to extend it. You have to make a decision.
Yeah.
Right.
That's all up there.
That
puts the appeal process on them.
And then the appeal process goes in whether we want it or not.
Right.
That's where.
Aren't there areas that the USGS has never even looked at, and they just assume that this is that way until somebody disputes it?
Not our issue.
Did they use satellite?
Not our issue.
Not into making USGS maps.
Right. That's.
I believe they use a lot of technical stuff in satellite.
But if that's wrong, why should we base our decision on it?
Because we don't.
Right.
We can only go with the information we have.
We don't make the determination on it. So what happens after?
So we're approving something that's wrong just because it's.
We don't know it's wrong.
Well, yes, we do.
It's not our issue.
That's what gives them the right of the appeal process.
Right.
So if we don't go forward, then they don't have an appeal process, and this wouldn't go anywhere. And I think it's going to go at one point. I think it's time that people move forward, do the appeal process, do what you want to do, and we all move forward legally and move through this.
Can I ask a question about so I'm like brand new at this. I'm old, but I'm brand new. Obviously this could be expensive on our part, I guess, where the people that would file the appeal. So we're talking about legal bills on our part. Is that correct? Is that how you understand something like this? Because I think if the town hears what's going on, and they say, as a town, and I'm not sure you can even do this, as a town, we dispute the very map we're using. You have nothing to do with that. You can't like say to whoever the appropriate authorities are, is even as a town, we dispute whether or not this is an accurate map. Based upon your knowledge of what people who live there know, they believe they know.
There's probably a process in the federal
mapping
section to handle these things. We've never run it. It's way above what we do, what we normally would do. I have no idea how it's done, but we don't have the process of investigating. We're really here to decide on what's brought before us, not going out and doing a lot of the investigation ourselves. We're all volunteers that meet.
I understand. Pembroke itself, not just the neighbors, Pembroke itself has an interest in protecting its wetlands.
Well, that's correct, and we have too. And this is why I suggested 30 days. If somebody has a way of disputing this map,
it wouldn't.
Then we would be entertained. Even if someone comes in with some sort of thing and says the map may be wrong, maybe then we can push it. But right now we're saying, and not that we doubt that you people are right. You're saying one thing and the map is saying something else, and we're in the middle and saying, you know, we've got to decide, and our regulations say that we use the map when there's nothing else to tell us other than that.
Because 30 days, that sounds a little rushed to me. We're private citizens too, and the people that are doing the work are not in that sense. This is what they do.
We're saying 30 days. If in 30 days you are in the midst of something that you haven't ready to present, you can write a letter to the board, call us, and ask for an extension of what's there, and have a reason for doing it, not just I want another 30. But if you're working on something, the board would most probably grant it to you.
If all the neighbors are like in their bathing suits swimming out there, would that be evidence we could send?
That's one thing you could do.
Yeah.
No, I'd be a little chilly right now.
Right. Again,
I don't think anybody is questioning the validity of lot lines, and it's really not questioning the map. It's questioning whether that's a intermittent stream river, or river.
Going by the line in the U.S., the geological survey map, which is what we're forced to make a decision on. It is an intermittent stream, and that's the same that we came up with it. And that's just where, that's what we have to base our decision on. If there's any appeal or any delay, that would be up to the representative to approve or deny it. If he chooses not, then we have to vote. And that's, then your appeal process can start. I don't know if it's the town of Pembroke's position to dispute in order to, just to answer your question, I don't know if it's the town of Pembroke's position to dispute a United States Geological Survey map. I just don't know. Right. You know, it's, if I was to tell you yes or no, either way, it would be incorrect information. So I don't want to do that, you know.
How old is that map?
That we're getting the information from.
The Geological Survey?
2015, Mass. GIS.
2015.
Which references the USGS.
Okay. Wait, those maps are available. You could see it, and if there is a process to review it, that might be the way to go.
Well, I mean, I think they don't, I'm sure when the Geological Survey is done, it's just like, yep, that hasn't changed, this hasn't changed, or whatever it might be.
Right.
But when was it determined to be an intermittent stream?
I can't.
30 years ago, 20
right.
years ago, last year.
Yeah, we didn't make the map, so
right.
I
mean, so that's something that needs to be looked into. I would think that the Conservation Commission would be very interested to know what their wetlands are and whether this is an intermittent stream or not.
I think whatever he's saying at this moment is that we are interested, you're interested, he's interested, and we're all interested
right.
over here. And we only have so much power and authority at
right.
this table today. But I'm sure that it's up to you if you want to give the 30 days or not. And
we can vote yes or no. We don't. Nobody tells us what we have to vote on.
No, but
right.
I understand, but if he would be gracious enough to give the 30 days, I think that would.
My client hired us to do a wetland delineation and survey it. We hired an independent consultant to create a report from which we put together the application, and it's based on the evidence that's written out in the Wetlands Protection Act. I don't know if I'd be doing my client a service by saying, take 30 days and take all the shots you can at a wetland delineation that was put together by a professional. My client's not here for me to even ask.
Right, right.
But as you said, you didn't have all of the actual information with you that you could present to us either.
Well, I don't have the Wetlands Protection
right.
Act. I don't know.
Yeah, we have copies of that.
Copies.
So.
Basically, his hands are tied just like
right.
ours.
No, I
right.
understand.
Right. 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 Right.
So I guess we have to vote on it.
Correct.
And then the appeals process starts.
Right.
The question is, if there's another wetland scientist has to be brought in, who's going to foot the bill?
That's.
Were you going to vote on that?
No.
I don't think we have the right to spend that money on an appeal for a private party.
Where it's not conservation.
Right.
Right. We don't.
But if it's a wetland, it is.
And whatever the thing is, the wetland is the wetland.
Right.
Yep.
We're accepting a wetland line.
Correct.
I think if I accept this plan tonight, I'm going to have to accept it with the word intermittent stream scratched whenever it's there. Because we're accepting a wetland, whether it's an intermittent stream or a perennial stream, the wetland is the same. That what would be different is the boundaries that are workable in the future.
Correct.
Bob, that's good. Okay, I said, no matter what, whether this said intermittent stream or river, these boundaries that you're okaying would remain the same.
Yeah, the wetland line is the same.
Yes.
It's just
only,
what you can do
it's
within.
Only the boundaries beyond how it's interpreted as the working boundaries.
So you're only voting on whether these lines are accurate. Has nothing to do with the stream.
Right. Other than it says things on the plan about being an intermittent stream. And if we cross those off, then we can accept this and fight the intermittent stream whenever
can we,
they bring something
can we
back
do
to
that?
Us. one way or the other, if they do. And if they don't, then it's, none of us have incurred greater expenses.
So I don't understand what they want to do.
I don't either.
We don't have the right to ask that.
Besides, it's
not here.
But doesn't that affect what happens?
Nope.
No, the wetland line is a wetland line. The wetlands are wetlands.
They can come closer to the wetland and put in a barn with horse manure going into the river.
They can't do anything without coming back before the board. This doesn't give them a permit to do anything except draw another plan with whatever they wanted to do. Would that be somewhat of a...
How it works is we don't know what we can do until we know where the lines are.
Right.
So that's why we come here first. We don't do a whole project design and then a flag or an intimate stream moves in. So the client doesn't spend $30,000 on design ahead of time.
Right.
So that's what the process is.
You asked for an ANRAD.
Yep.
And the ANRAD, I believe, is a wetland line delineation, not an intimate stream.
We do have in the ANRAD under number 3, indicate any other resource area boundaries that are delineated. We did delineate the top of bank, and we're indicating it as an intermittent stream, 1,150 linear feet.
You said top of bank, after top of bank,
intermittent stream.
Intermittent stream. Does an ANRAD cover us taking an intermittent stream?
We can...
I'm just showing you the form. So
what did you have, Rick?
We did the BBW.
In the future, if it is a stream or a brook, isn't that within our jurisdiction to have it? There's some question.
If you make a decision tonight, it's binding.
It's binding. So
right.
That's something that we're tying our hands if we do this, that we can't even say later that this was a stream that needs protection, if it is.
Right. We're going on the fact that we have now.
So we're basically putting ourselves in a position that if this is a stream, we can't, we tie our hands in the future.
We're just accepting an ANRAD.
Right, no, I know, but it. I got you.
Yep. But is it including the intermittent stream or not? Because he's saying it's in the plan, correct?
Right. You can approve the portions of the plan you think are accurate.
Okay. So we can approve from TB 29.
We can approve all of this.
To that. Well, that's what I'm saying. We can we take out TB 28 to TB 18, where it's claiming it's the intermittent stream. So we can approve these and this.
The intent is the whole thing. This bank is associated with an intermittent stream. This is so that's what we're trying to show, not just here to here.
So
just saying.
So he's asking for some vote on the whole thing.
Correct.
Thanks. However,
whether it is or isn't is not our determination. That's all I can say.
So can we not approve this?
Basically,
line?
We have to approve what's here.
Right.
Let them.
But he wants the entire thing to be voted on.
Yeah.
You can approve the wetland line, and you can leave this for later determination. You can approve the chopper bank is accurate and not make the determination whether it's...
Can I have a seat, please?
You can't talk there without...
You can't.
I can't?
No.
You can... I did. The determination that chopper bank is accurate, but...
Yeah.
It's not
because you can't do that.
Or
it's against the meeting law.
We all need prompting. Thank you.
Sorry.
I'll get a call button with a buzzer for you.
And then we'd have to reapply.
Which you could probably do on
the same
RDA.
Or the same. I would go the same process because I can't, you know, if they want to do some development, we can't even concept without knowing where we are.
Without being 100 or
something.
Right.
Trying to make everybody happy.
But to play the other side, if you know, if that does become a stream, then you're going to do all that design work, you know.
Well, I would
you'd be reversing it.
Right. I would.
So
if it's a perennial river, then we design it with those regulations in mind. If it's intermittent, we design it. We design based on the regulations. You know,
right.
Frontage,
right.
Yes.
Yes. Doing your drop line from
here.
No, I don't. And that's, I think it's all there.
Yeah.
But again, that's zoning board, that stuff like that. That's not this board's thing. So, do we have a motion for anything? Or?
What do you want us to
do?
You're on the chart. You can tell us we have.
That's what I was asking.
I think on behalf of my client, I would like you to vote on it. We had the, you know, the regulations say it's an intermittent stream based on the mapping, and that's why we put it that way.
Right.
And I don't have any other criteria to give to you while we're sitting here.
How long does the...
And as a concerned citizen again in a butter to this property, obviously the term intermittent stream, you know, is very important to us as opposed to a river.
Correct.
And what I didn't like about through the whole discussion that's been very good is that if you make that determination now, there's no going back. If I can prove that it's a river by getting water flow measurements or whatever the heck you do, who in their life has ever tried to determine an intermittent stream over, you know, a river? But whatever needs to be done,
right.
If you short circuit it by making the vote that it is an intermittent stream now, we're something.
No, it still gives you the appeal process.
No, it actually gives you the appeal process. Now, how long do they have to appeal this process?
10 days.
10 days.
10 days to, submit an appeal. Yes, to submit an appeal.
10 days to appeal this decision and go from there. And it's going to happen. I think this is what needs to happen.
Yep.
You know,
that's
in this case.
It's not this board's opinion.
Right.
So we'll
I'd like to find a way to do it without the appeal, but I don't see that we have any way that that's binding. I understand and I would sympathize with your position, but at the same time, we have to make a decision by what the regulations allow us to make a decision with. And this plan appears to have got the regulations covered.
I think this is a pretty common position in a river project.
I've had it always the other way around. I've never had it this way before.
Right, from the proponent.
Yeah.
But it's the abutters always have the same determination.
Right, it's one or, the
same
other.
Same one, excuse me.
Determination. Yeah, everything comes to me. Okay.
I do feel that, like I say, we're good people, so, you know, that's not the issue. I do sense on my part, as brand new to this kind of process, that when you say it's out of your hands, but what you're also... help me understand. You're also saying that if this board comes across something that they feel or believe is of concern to a higher authority based on behalf of the town, you're saying there's no way this board can kick it up to another group that says, you know, the town has an interest in this too, not just the abutters. And said, that on behalf of the town, we need to kick it up another level to another committee that does have the authority if you don't. I would assume you have some kind of mission that when you recognize something that is of this kind of nature, that on behalf of the town, you have some other committee say, we don't know. We're going to appeal it to this group. Say there's something else, because I don't know why. The federal government has said what it is. So the Pembroke's position is we always take the federal government's word. Period. That's the end of every story for us. Then that's what it is.
Right.
It's not.
We are governed by not only town and laws as well, and we are forced to follow the laws. And the client has just as many rights as you do. What you do with your end of the process is on you, and what he does with his end of the process is on him.
The town has no compelling interest in itself.
Why are we even here if he does what he wants and they do what they want?
Right. The town does not make a determination on a USGS map. They don't.
What we're up with here is kind of a due process, and you have the appeal, and that I think it's a good way to start out. And I think being residents in the
We can't give advice either way.
The appeal doesn't come here. The appeal goes to DEP.
Right.
And that is really our next step is DEP. We can't go to DEP and just ask them to do anything. It has to go through these appeal stages.
Department of Environmental Protection. That's in case anybody didn't know.
Right. And I think you'll get protection, honestly. You know.
We don't offer opinions either.
An interesting point is that, yes, we're here because we're abutters and we can see where we're abutting against the this property. The land that this right-of-way property that was taken from my family by eminent domain, is that owned by the town or is it owned by the Conservation Commission? Who owns this property right here?
I don't know.
Is there an easement on it?
No, it's not.
Which part?
Town of Pembroke?
Because I heard that, I thought that the Conservation Commission got it from the town. I may be wrong. I know the town took it.
It's all the town.
They wanted to build they wanted to put in a road through that property for rear egress to the school.
That was school, yeah.
And they took it from the town.
I'm pretty sure that's still the town. I've looked that up not too long ago, and I'm pretty sure we found it was still the town's.
Okay, because they were denied building the road because of the wetlands.
Because of the wetlands, but it's still town property.
Okay, but
I'm 99%. I'd have to go back and the records right here, but we looked at that not too long ago, and it was my recollection that was still town. A lot of that in that area was still town, because they had talked about the golf course and all going through there many years ago.
Not 50 years ago, I'll bet. But the point is that what I was getting to is, if that is town land and they were denied the ability to put a road in there, access because of wetland, doesn't that also give me, I'm trying to think of what I've got to do in 10 days to make this an intermittent stream into a river. And I have to think that the town had to investigate that for a road, and they were denied. Now, if they were denied to do any building in that area,
they could have been denied just for the wetland, because they only can fill in so much wetland on a road.
Exactly.
But I don't know where the stream is in that piece compared to that piece of road.
But, well, we don't have to present our case.
It's a different.
To file the paperwork within that 10 days.
I guess I was just asking for my information. This may be something that we need to go, wait a minute.
Right. And that's a different parcel of property? That's a different parcel of property where that road was projected to come out?
No, this is right. It abuts this parcel D841. I'm on the other side, which the map, 145 is on the other side.
Right.
This is the town land that comes right through it, and it entails all of,
all of this.
Everything right in here.
Yep.
In here. All of this wetlands property that's been all flagged out in here. If the town had a problem with it then, the town should have a problem with it now, doing any building.
Yeah, and there's nobody from the town here.
But we're not having a hearing for building. It's splitting the hairs, but it's what we have to do. Yeah.
Can we?
So again, in a nutshell, you're just voting on okaying that these lines are correct.
Yes.
The 100 wetland buffer, the upland wetland buffer. I would love to have you take intermittent stream off all the paperwork, but I don't have any say in that, apparently. So if these lines are correct and you agreed that they are correct, now the next step is how much they can encroach those lines, depending upon whether it's a stream intermittent stream or a river. That denies them what they can do within these boundaries. Is that correct?
Yes. The boundaries that are anything that's shown here is assuming that it's an intermittent stream.
Right. And the boundaries would be the same whether it's a river or an intermittent stream.
The wetland boundaries would be.
Right. Yes, these boundaries that you're voting on.
Perhaps, and we've talked about it, maybe you didn't understand. When there's a perennial stream, the first 100 feet off of a perennial stream, the bank of the perennial stream, mm-hmm. is what I like to refer to as untouchable zone. It's the what they call riverfront property. Then the next 100 feet is what we now would refer to as a buffer zone area. So that, in fact, we have jurisdiction over 200 feet from the top of the bank.
From the top of the bank.
In this particular case, we have jurisdiction up to where you see that 100-foot wetland buffer line.
Okay.
So if you know where the stream is and you pull out your ruler and you go 200 feet, that would be. It doesn't say that they can't work within the 100-foot buffer zone here or the second 100-foot off of the riverfront. You can work in there under the right conditions that have been approved by the local conservation commission or the Department of Environmental Protection. A 100-foot buffer does not mean that it can't do any work. It just means that whatever is done there is under the control, or under the approval of the Conservation Commission.
Correct.
One last question for me. Whether it be a stream or brook, the intermittent, or don't all the rules and regs on siltation and all those other things all apply down the road?
Yep.
There you go.
Right.
So I missed that. The last
whether
part.
It's a brook, a road, an intermittent, I mean, a brook, a stream, an intermittent, or a river, all the regulations that will protect you and everything there are all in place, and siltation, all those things. So,
it falls under
a whole different thing. This is just to delineate what is there.
Right. Okay.
The construction needs to meet performance standards for
correct.
Each
right. correct.
Resource area.
Yes, it does. Anybody want to make a motion to close the hearing?
With regret, I move that we accept the delineation as presented on the plan.
Okay. Do we need a motion to close first? Or?
Motion to close.
Motion to close has been made.
Second.
And seconded. And Bob made a motion to accept the ANRAD as it's laid out here. From the 2015 map and USGS map. Motion's been made.
Second.
And seconded. Any further discussion on this? No? Okay. All in favor?
Aye.
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 Opposed?
No.
Ayes have it.
Okay.
Thank you very much, guys.
You're welcome.
Appreciate
so the
your efforts
process
there.
For you folks now.
Yeah, I don't have to read that because it's not a notice of intent.
I wouldn't know how much you need those.
Right? I don't have to read.
They go right to the end. They can work it all out. Yeah, they can work it all out.
Okay. Oh, I didn't think I had to because it's a notice of intent. All right.
There's a green guys. We didn't ask for. All
right. I didn't think we had to. It's not a notice of intent. All right. And please note that any person aggrieved by this decision has the right of appeal within 10 business days. Please contact our office or DEP if you need assistance.
Yeah, we would ask how they'll go about that.
Absolutely.
Thank you, gentlemen.
You're welcome. Thank you.
Thank you.
Is there any way to get a copy of the report of the stream study that they did?
It's in the yeah. I'll be here around 8:30 tomorrow morning. If you want to drop by, I can give it to you. And do you send me an electronic copy of that so I can?
Yep, absolutely. Yep, no problem. Thank you.
Thank you.
So that's, I mean, that's still going to be the same amount, whether it's a stream.
It's not our decision.
No, but I'm saying it's still going to be off 100 feet no matter what.
I can't make a decision. It's faulty maps.
Or questionable.
Yeah, questionable, right.
I want the federal government telling us what to do, but that's as you follow.
You don't have to.
They've got to question it. It's not us.
That's why you can vote yes or no.
Right. You see that town of Falmouth can sue for $1 million and lost?
Yep.
Okay. That was because of stuff like that.
Scott, can you toss me a candy? Thank you.
Okay. Is our next one still here or?
What time is it anyway?
All right, it's now 8:42. And we'd like to open our 7:50 hearing for a notice of intent. 73 Taylor Street, Hashem, DEP, file SE56-978. For construction of a new roadway and infrastructure for a 6-lot subdivision. Word. Yes, that would be the next thing I asked for.
Can you give me the folder? Thank you.
Yes, sir.
You know, here, hold on. How's that, Scott?
Yeah.
All right. And who is representing the project tonight?
How you doing? Chris Anderson with Merrill Engineers and Land Surveyors.
Hi, Chris.
Just need to be on camera. Is that
No, it's okay.
No.
And then Owen
County, Stonewood
Homes.
How you doing?
This piece of property we already have an ANRAD on?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And the lines shown on these plans are the same as the ANRAD that was approved.
Yeah.
I'm sorry.
All right, with the little.
Yeah.
Yeah, I can give you guys a brief overview of the project. Here we have a 23-acre parcel of land off of 73 Taylor Street. Like you said, we already have an ORAD issued for the wetland line shown here in blue on the plan. The applicant, Downwind Realty Trust, is represented by Owen Kelly here. And we are proposing to subdivide the piece into 6 lots for single-family residential homes and build up approximately 650-foot cul-de-sac. Some of the work you can see will be taking place within the buffer zone. The buffer zone is depicted by that green line right here. Presently on the site, there's an existing single-family dwelling in this area, accessed by a gravel drive. And for the most part, this site is completely wooded. To get back to the wetland area, the wetlands with this light green color here. It is in a priority habitat. We did file a MESA filing with Natural Heritage using preliminary plans for this that haven't changed. It was actually an extra lot in the previous plan, so there's less impact in this, and they issued a no take for any environmental endangered species. Prior to the commencement of any work taking place for either roadway construction, drainage construction, you can see a drainage basin located here. There's proposed easement in these two lots for the drainage basin. The limit of work line is this dashed red line, which will propose erosion control barriers. I think we have a 12-inch silt sock proposed for that area. All of the runoff from the road will be caught by catch basins and pitched downward. The road basically slopes down by 20 feet from the entrance there. And We'll go to a pre-treatment unit right on the top of the berm here and discharged into the infiltration basin, which is capable of handling a 100-year storm line. Some other areas where some discharge is caught will be these three rain gardens here. Basically, the driveways we have on this lot development plan slope down, so they will pitch off of that into grass-lined swales and land in those rain gardens for treatment before entering any wetland area.
Can you tell me what a rain garden is?
It's basically a little depression that has certain plantings that will remove sediment from any runoff from the driveway. We also have proposed a little P-stone diaphragm on the edge of the driveways. So any runoff that comes off of that that has sediment in it, it will first hit the P-stone, then the grass line swale, and end up in the rain garden, which we have details. Right. Yeah. And in the operation and construction maintenance plans, we'll have some language on how to maintain those rain gardens, and that will be the responsibility of that lot owner.
It'll be of the individual lot owner itself, or is it a homeowners association?
That will be deeded.
Right.
The responsibility will be deeded at that lot.
What about the bigger one down the end? Does that fall under the association, or?
It's not. Wouldn't be an association.
Okay.
So this it'll be up for acceptance eventually.
Yep, you can. In the stormwater report, there's a full long-term pollution prevention plan, and then there's construction and
green one
plan
right there. Okay, that's there's another one here, and that's the stormwater plan that was submitted for the project.
The overflow is basically, you know, once it reaches the limit, which it shouldn't because it is sized for a 100-year storm event, the treatment and the sediment removal should have already taken place, and it will be overland flow into the wetland. But they are sized appropriately.
So it'll all flow away from people's houses, and there won't be any problems in the future.
We are showing proposed dry wells to collect any roof runoff on each of the lots that are within the conservation's jurisdiction. Those are also sized appropriately for a 100-year storm event. Each lot will go through an individual notice of intent filing that we are proposing work within the buffer at the time of individual lot development. There will be in-ground septic systems. We've done test pits out there, and each of the systems has been sized appropriately and shown outside of the 100-foot buffer. That'll be more definitively designed through each individual development, but we're confident to be able to keep that all out of the buffer zone.
We have a project just down the road here off Oldham. This is pretty similar. Half of them are near wetland resource, half of them are similar catch basins, things like that.
Yep, basically a fully compliant DEP stormwater management system. I won't get too in-depth into the actual report, but it's currently under review through planning board. Tyler Nims is the engineer reviewing. So I believe he'll be reviewing for conservation as well. Is that how that's going to work?
The planning board is using Tyler Nims instead of Merrill Associates as the peer review engineer for the property. Is it? So.
Right.
Well, we're not like the council on board on that subject. We will be given access to Tyler's reports, and also we don't have to hire or duplicate the effort.
Yeah. I don't know how Pembroke usually shares information. If you want us to coordinate that, or do you guys coordinate with them?
I believe he may have already received this information, but that's something we can double check and definitely get the ball.
As long as we're okay with with you people.
Because
he
has
no
full
interview
of the project.
We'll use Tyler as if there's any areas that aren't covered on the one.
Absolutely.
We'll use him so
right.
Is that a motion? Motion?
What's that a motion?
We'll put it there, so we'll make it all at the end. Just so we don't forget it.
That's pretty much a brief overview. If you have any questions or comments at this time, we don't fully expect to close anything right now, as it's still under review with the planning board, and there likely will be some changes to the plan. So we are planning on coming back, but we definitely wanted to get the project out there and get initial comments, questions for myself or Owen.
What's up to Stahl's property? I think so, right? We have stream that runs on the tail of the
stream. Is there a
Stahl's property?
There's an old reservoir, this line.
Stumpy.
Right here. Stump Pond is
Stump Pond, yeah, that's drain.
A ways away. It's actually a very big parcel. If you look at the lotting sheets on that, we're leaving the majority of it as open space beyond.
We're talking about going down Taylor Street. East, it's up on Taylor Street there. Somewhere a bit down there, there is a stream, but it's more than 100 foot off of this property, I believe.
Yeah, and I think that's something that will come up with the ANRAD process.
Yeah. As you have not finished your planning board, I think you said.
Yeah, I think February.
Really looking for us to close now where you I don't think we want to do that at all.
Just coming to say hi.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah. In other words, we're here to be informed and so we can be thinking about what we have going on. And when planning board is ready, you'll give us the green light to really look at it. We'll be working together. So the green light comes out together.
Yeah. And hopefully Tyler's already been reviewing the project for 2 weeks now, so the next round we can hopefully incorporate his comments and get everything tightened up.
Okay.
It looks like a good.
Yeah.
I know the land.
It's like any piece of open property. I never like to see anything.
It's all Owen's fault. It's this guy.
I like to see it done.
At least it's done well.
I remember you.
It's time in all the open spots.
I know.
I don't know if you guys have been on a conference. Like it's all staked and signed.
It's done. Yeah, yeah.
Maybe the first.
Awesome. All right. So.
Pretty good.
So we don't. We don't have to close or anything.
No,
we're just looking at
continue.
It.
Right. Continue. All this stuff. You think you want us to continue? I mean, we can continue every week, but we prefer, if it's going to be 3 or 4 weeks, not to have a time
to put it on the agenda. Every 2 weeks now.
We should be here every week, unless it's a holiday, and not the 30th of the month, whatever it is, the 29th.
Yeah, the 30th is for a different situation. I think most of Town Hall is going to be shut down, so you might be on the phone.
Oh, okay, that's
check your schedule. I know we're not going to be here on the 30th.
You're not going to be here on the 30th?
Correct.
Okay.
So it'll be the week after.
Week after the 30th.
So you're meeting on the...
So, we potentially could get the comments from Tyler in the next week or two, so maybe we could shoot for something mid-February and push it back.
Yeah, that way you guys could review some.
Yeah, that's fine. And just let us know if it's good, bad, or indifferent. If you got to do redesigns, just let us know and we'll... 27th.
The
27th,
you guys?
Well, the
20th
is
the
school vacation.
Yeah.
And the going out is the 13th.
Yep.
So
the 27th, you guys are here?
Yes.
So what are we planning for that week?
We're also here for the 13th and the 6th.
Did anybody else have any comments on it? Did you folks have anything?
Oh, no, sure. I'm just, I'm here on Elizabeth Geisler's behalf. She's at 45 Taylor.
Okay, yep. I think she said that. We told her we'd be having another meeting probably in a month or so.
That's right. That's what I was going to say, yeah.
Excellent. Okay.
Good.
All right, so we'll carry it. We're going to continue this hearing.
Continue to the.
Thank you.
I think it's the
27th of February.
That's second. What she was saying. We'll take a look. If that doesn't work out, we'll
tentatively do the 13th, and if we have revised plans, just to keep it moving.
Great.
If not, we'll push it back.
Perfect. Sounds good.
February 13th at 7:40.
Motion's been made and seconded.
I didn't make the motion.
To continue, huh?
I did not make the motion.
No, it wasn't you.
Bucket.
I seconded.
Rick seconded it. So it's been made and seconded. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. When's the continued date, Mayor?
That would be February 13th.
13th, and it may vary to the 27th.
Yep.
Right. Ellen's buying us all flowers. Okay.
Okay, and there's a motion to do the review. Planning board?
Let's just take them. It's from the public.
Tyler Nims, I move that we coordinate with Tyler Nims and the planning board for reviews for our
stormwater
and so forth, and that if we need to have something other than the planning board, is to attempt to use Tyler Nims as possible.
If we can coordinate, I think we already got him the notes of intent stuff, but if we don't, we can coordinate getting that to
him. It could be dangerous with us.